Deputy Minister of Industry and Trade of the Russian Federation, Admiral Saxena, CWP&A, Admiral Harish, DGND, Admiral Sunil Lamba, Chairman, National Maritime Board, distinguished delegates, friends from the Russian delegation, a very warm good afternoon to all of you. And I should, at the outset, thank FICCI for organizing such a relevant discourse here, because this interaction, what we are having, shipbuilding and nation building together, it couldn't come at a more opportune time. We are having a new government in place, a government which has pushed forward strongly on what we call the Make in India vision, and a government which has come back strongly, clearly understanding what has been the deficiencies in the Make in India 1.0 with a view and vision to push forward Make in India 2.0. So at this point of time, talking about shipbuilding and what we could actually do together is quite interesting. For me, coming from Cochin Shipyard, and I've been in the shipbuilding industry for more than 30 years, let me just paint a very, very vivid picture of what we are today. It all looks good on the naval shipbuilding front in India, because as has been explained in various plenary sessions before, the Indian Navy, due to its vision, invested about 50 years back to build a strong naval design capability in the country, and today we are reaping the benefits of that. So today the country can actually say with pride that defense platforms can actually be built in the country. I just stop it at that at this point, because we are saying that we can actually, from a technology point of view, we can handle practically any defense platform in the country. So it looks good. On the commercial shipbuilding side, it's been discussed earlier that at a point of time, India touched almost close to 4 to 5% of the global shipbuilding, and then we slipped. So if we really look at it, it was more of a flash in the pan due to a set of reasons that we were able to achieve that. My company also, Cochin Shipyard, we did quite well. We exported more than 50 vessels out of Cochin Shipyard into some of the best countries in the world. Now let's look at this critically. When we look at this critically, including on the defense platforms, what we are building, the point question which we need to ask is, are we competitive? And what is competitiveness all about? It's not just about the money part of it. It's that classical triangle of quality, cost, and on-time delivery. So if you're really looking at competitiveness from a all these three points of view, because any client, whether it's a commercial client or whether it's a defense client, wants vessels to be delivered on time, as per the quality specifications to particular benchmark standards, and to be delivered within agreed costs. So the question is, are we able to be competitive? And I can say with a fair bit of conviction that we are not competitive. We would miss out of these 3 points. We may hold 1 or 1.5, or maybe we may hold 2, but we are not in a position to hold all the 3 points together. There have been times at which, from speaking from our experiences, we have held 2 out of these 3 points well, but then the third one has slipped. And if any one of these slips, I say that we are not competitive. So we need to find out why we are not competitive. There are probably a lot of reasons. I'm not dwelling upon those subjects at this point of time. Whenever we come into a meeting like this, we always see a fair bit of pessimism, especially post-2008 after the Lehman collapse and the bad international shipping markets that we had globally. But we fail to realize that this bad shipbuilding market or the bad times is not just for India or for Indian shipyards, it's for everybody in the world. So if somebody has, somebody like a Hyundai or Daewoo has invested heavily and they were amongst the top, the fall has also been that strong. So when the Korean government had to pump in $10 billion to sustain some of the shipyards. And when a company like Daewoo goes bad, it's equally bad. So the troubles are all, it's probably universal. So let us not get carried away by something wrong is happening in India. We are also part of the larger system. There may be specific reasons that's happening in India. But the general tendency would be to go and blame the government to a large extent. Yes, we can all do that. This is a democratic country. We can go and blame the government. But blaming the government alone is not going to suffice our requirements. This country has got a lot of other requirements. This country has got a lot of priorities. And if shipbuilding and shipping has to be at the top of the priorities, we in the fraternity also need to do something that we actually deserve to be at the top of the priorities.